about the law of independent assortment statement we have already done. I'll be explaining the meaning of this again when you will be doing the cross for this. Okay, so jo humne statement left kiya tha, that is jo statement humne left kiya tha, that is the law of independent assortment. It is the fourth law, right? Law of independent assortment, that's the last conclusion made by Mendel. That is the last law given by Mendel. It is law of independent assortment. As the name says, independent means that one trait's features or the factors, they are independent of the other trait's factors. Okay, so that is the independent assortment. Kaise hua ye main aapko batati hu. Hum logon ne isko start kar diya tha with the parents. How we selected the parents? We took an example of seed shape and seed color. ठीक है, हमने सीड शेप और सीड कलर की एग्जाम्पल ली थी और मैंने आपको ये भी बताया था कि आपने इस एग्जाम्पल वाइज आप लोगों ने सारे जो फीचर्स हैं वो सेम वे में आगे पीछे रखने हैं इसमें. जैसे शेप है तो शेप के फैक्टर्स आगे रहेंगे फॉलोड बाय द सीड कलर के फैक्टर्स. ठीक है, सो अकॉर्डिंगली वी हैव स्टडीड दैट हाउ द पेरेंट्स आर टू बी फॉर्म्ड, राइट? सो selecting the pure breeds, that is the first step given by Mendel in his experiments. So pure breeds mein hamare paas first kya aata hai, that is a pure dominant which is having both the features as dominant, that is round and yellow. Pure dominant ka matlab kya hota hai, genotypically bhi wo pure hoga. Theek hai, pure ka matlab hai ki wo pure genotypically bhi hai. And pure recessive on the other hand, wrinkled and green. So genotypically also it is pure wrinkled and green. Till this we have done, right? After this there is a gametes formation. Gametes formation, ab ye law apply karta hai, that is on the gametogenesis, hai na, at the time of gametogenesis. The statement that you people have written, if you will look onto that statement, you will see that what was the statement according to this law. At the time of gamete formation, that is the gametogenesis, the two factors of a trait get assorted in such a manner that they are not dependent upon the other factors of other traits. Hai na, kehne ka matlab kya hai ki ye jo r hai that can accompany with any of the y's. Theek hai, yahan pe to koi zyada farak nahi nazar aayega aapko f1 ke liye, lekin f2 mein aapko nazar aayega ki ye assort hota hai independent of each other, to characters bhi different de sakta hai. Aisa kuch zaruri nahi hai, jaise maine example liya tha humans mein, कि जो टॉल हाइटेड है उनकी ब्राउन आइज है ना, ऐसा जरूरी फीचर नहीं है. दिस इज नॉट एट ऑल अ कंपल्सरी फीचर. ओके, दिस इज नॉट एट ऑल अ कंपल्सरी फीचर, अ फैक्ट, राइट? सो दिस इज व्हेन द गैमेट्स आर बीइंग फॉर्म्ड, द गैमेट्स प्रोड्यूस्ड विल बी द फैक्टर्स ऑफ अ ट्रेट गेट अरेंज्ड इंडिपेंडेंट ऑफ द अदर फैक्टर. ठीक है, तो हमारे पास जो दो गैमेट्स बने दे आर कैपिटल आर वाई एंड कैपिटल आर कैपिटल वाई. Okay, similarly the gametes from here you can make up four gametes also. Agar aap inme pairing karoge to this way two pairs hai na, and this also r is going to form two pairs, means four pairs you can make four here, but it'll be very much you can say time consuming because all of them are same, so I have reduced from four to two. Theek hai, you can write even one, aap single bhi likh sakte ho agar sare gametes same hai. Ye dekho dono same hai na, to ye bhi same hai. Theek hai, but just to confirm that our answer is going right, so uske liye we are providing two of the gametes. Okay, now after parents gametes, the next generation is f1 generation. F1 kaise banti hai, when the gametes they undergo the fusion from the different parents, hai na? To ab humne wahi wala tt cross wala hi humne sara pattern follow karte rehna. So this is the first fusion possible, right? As a result, when you are going to combine again for the shape, first you are going to write the two factors. ठीक है, दोनों factors पहले shape के लिखने, followed by दोनों factors color. ठीक है, ऐसा नहीं करना कि r y r y, ऐसे नहीं लिखना. ठीक है, r's का pair इकट्ठा कर दो, जैसे भी r's की nature है इकट्ठा कर दो, और y's की जो भी nature है उनको इकट्ठा कर दो. ठीक है, that should always be a single trait, should always be in a pair. Okay, similarly this gamete can fuse with another one, resulting in again capital R, small r, capital Y, small y. Another possibility can be this fusion, capital R, small r, capital Y, small y. And the last possible can be this fusion, that is capital R, small r, capital Y, small y. Again, as in monohybrid, we got the result, that is they are pure hybrids. And now, where also capital T, small t, it was pure hybrid, this is also capital R, small r. एक ट्रेड के लिए प्योर हाइब्रिड है, कैपिटल वाई स्मॉल वाई दूसरे ट्रेड के लिए भी प्योर हाइब्रिड है. सो दिस इज अ हाइब्रिड 100%. व्हाट वी आर गेटिंग इज जीनोटिपिकली कैपिटल आर स्मॉल आर कैपिटल वाई स्मॉल वाई एज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ F1 जनरेशन इन अ डायहाइब्रिड क्रॉस वी गेट ऑल ऑर्गेनिजम्स एज कैपिटल आर स्मॉल आर कैपिटल वाई स्मॉल वाई डन. आफ्टर दिस इफ यू लुक ऑन टू द फीनोटाइप्स each of these, अगर आपके pair में capital है तो means that is going to express capital alphabet है यानी dominating gene है तो that is going to express itself है ना. so in this pair what is the feature round and in this pair what is the feature going to be yellow. so round and yellow, round and yellow, round and yellow, round and yellow. so means what, that is all of these organisms are having round and yellow phenotype. Got it? Okay. Now the next is the third step. After the selection of pure breeds, hybridization, artificial hybridization, and now the third step, that is the selfing. अब selfing, selfing क्या था? जब ही हमने F1 generation के offsprings में से कोई भी randomly दो choice करने हैं as for the next generation's parents. ठीक है, so सारे same है. so what we are going to do is we are going to select any of these two because all are same, so hardly matters है ना. so हमने क्या किया, कोई भी दो means हमने दोनों ये वाले pairs लिख दिए, जो सारे ही आए थे तो वही वाले pairs हमने लिख दिए hybrids. done, that is now going to give rise to the next generation. now here is actually इंडिपेंडेंट असॉर्टमेंट का आपको ज्यादा अच्छे से क्लियर पता चलेगा कि एक फैक्टर किसी एक ट्रेड का दूसरे ट्रेड के फैक्टर्स के ऊपर डिपेंड नहीं करता. मींस दिस आर कैन अकंपनी विद दिस वन है ना. अगर ये दोनों का पेयर बनता तो हमारे पास कैपिटल आर कैपिटल वाई पेयर आता तो हमारे पास पॉसिबल करेक्टर्स क्या दे रहा है, ये वाला गैमेट क्या देगा, पॉसिबल फीचर्स दैट इज राउंड एंड येलो है ना, फीचर डिफरेंस आ रहा है राइट. अगर यही वाला इसके साथ मीट कर जाए, अगर पेयर करना है कि मीट के अंदर जाना है इंडिपेंडेंटली सॉल्व होते हैं तो ये वाला अगर पेयर मीट कर जाए कैपिटल आर स्मॉल आर तो क्या होगा, इट इज गोइंग टू गिव राइज टू द अनदर गैमेट. पॉसिबल फीचर्स ये क्या प्रोवाइड करने वाला है, राउंड एंड ग्रीन. ये राउंड एंड येलो था तो ये राउंड एंड ग्रीन, गैमेट्स की नेचर डिफरेंट हो रही है ना देखो, जस्ट बिकॉज क्योंकि उनका पेयरिंग जो है दूसरे फैक्टर्स के साथ यानी दूसरे ट्रेड के फैक्टर्स के साथ वो इंडिपेंडेंट है. ठीक है, थर्ड पॉसिबल गैमेट क्या होगा, दिस स्मॉल आर कैन पेयर विद द कैपिटल वाई. अब ये पॉसिबल फीचर क्या दे रहा है, कैपिटल आर सॉरी स्मॉल आर कैपिटल वाई, दिस इज गोइंग टू गिव रिंकल्ड एंड येलो है ना. और दिस स्मॉल आर कैन ऑल्सो बी विद द स्मॉल वाई, इसके साथ भी आ सकता था. एंड पॉसिबल फीचर इट इज गोइंग टू प्रोवाइड इज रिंकल्ड एंड ग्रीन. अब चारों गैमेट्स की नेचर अलग अलग होगी, दिस इज वॉट इंडिपेंडेंट असॉर्टमेंट इज. जिसने कहा कि जब गैमेट्स बनने हैं उस समय पे गैमेट्स बनते पे सारे जो फैक्टर्स हैं एक ट्रेड के वो किसी भी दूसरे फैक्टर्स के दूसरे ट्रेड्स जो हैं उनके फैक्टर्स के साथ कैसे भी अरेंज हो सकते हैं, कोई जरूरी नहीं है कि दिस हैज टू कम विद ओनली दिस. जैसे हमारी फर्स्ट में आ रहा ना कैपिटल आर और कैपिटल वाई कंबाइन कर रहे हैं तो ऐसा जरूरी नहीं है कि हर बार हमें कैपिटल आर और कैपिटल वाई ही कंबाइन करना है ना. इट कैन बी इन एनी फॉर्म. डन, नाउ दिस स्टेटमेंट इज क्लियर. दक्षिता इट वाज अ डाउट फॉर यू. हां जी बेटा, अब स्टेटमेंट क्लियर हो गया, स्टिल एनी कंफ्यूजन?
यस मैम, इट्स थैंक यू.
ओके ओके. एंड सिमिलरली द फोर गैमेट्स विल बी प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय दिस पेरेंट ऑल्सो है ना. कौन कौन से, सेम वे में कैपिटल आर कैपिटल वाई कैपिटल आर स्मॉल वाई स्मॉल आर कैपिटल वाई स्मॉल आर स्मॉल आर, दीज आर द गैमेट्स प्रोड्यूस्ड. सेम फॉर्म में, जैसे ये चार इधर बने हैं सेम ही, क्योंकि पेरेंट सेम थे, तो यही वाले चार पॉसिबल यहाँ पे के मिल जाएंगे. नो एल्स पेयर इज पॉसिबल. पांचवा जी में कोई और पेयर है तो आप बता दो, नथिंग एल्स, राइट. सो दिस वॉज गेमीट्स ऑफ द सेकेंड जनरेशन, डन. हेयर नेक्स्ट इज एफ टू जनरेशन. अब जब हम पेयरिंग करेंगे, अगर तो हम इन लाइन्स के साथ करें, जैसे ये लाइन रिप्रेजेंटेशन है, तो लाइन्स के साथ करेंगे तो ये बहुत ज्यादा समान लेने वाला है और बहुत ज्यादा हॉचपॉच हो जाएगा. इसके लिए मैंने आपको तब करवाया था, बोला भी था कि जब हम मोनोहाइब्रिड क्रॉस बना रहे थे, कि डाईहाइब्रिड में एफ टू आपको पुनेट स्क्वायर से ही रिप्रेजेंट करनी पड़ती है. लाइन्स वाला जिसको ईजी लगता है यू कैन यूज दिस, बट फॉर एफ टू जनरेशन इन अ डाईहाइब्रिड क्रॉस यू हैव टू क्रिएट अ पुनेट स्क्वायर. You can't make this spider's web here, है ना. आपको पूरा इतना सारा बड़ा जाल नहीं बना देना है, क्योंकि ये बहुत ज्यादा पॉसिबिलिटी. वन इज गोइंग टू फ्यूज विद ऑल फोर, देन द सेकेंड इज गोइंग टू फ्यूज विद ऑल फोर. ऐसा कितना सारा वेब लाइक स्ट्रक्चर बन जाएगा, विच इज गोइंग टू बी कंफ्यूजिंग, है ना. तो उसकी वजह से वी विल बी क्रिएटिंग द पुनेट स्क्वायर, डन. ओके, सो नाउ टू शो द एफ टू जनरेशन, आई एम कॉन्टिन्यूइंग हेयर, यू कैन कॉन्टिन्यू नेक्स्ट टू दिस. If you have a space on the same page, the F2 generation, for the F2 generation, you people know that I already told you, the number of gametes decides that what the number of the squares will be in a Punnett square, है ना. जैसे हमने monohybrid में किया था तो 2x2 का cross बनाया था, 2 rows and 2 columns. यहाँ पे 4 gametes है तो 4x4, यानी 4 columns and 4 rows we have to be. Okay, so this I am erasing. But you will not be erasing it from your notebook, okay, for the space. So now we are going to create a 4x4 square, okay. So you create this as a big square, because in the smaller boxes of this, we are to write both the genotype as well as phenotypes, okay. So you create a big square like this, right, here. 4 rows and 4 columns you have to create. That is a box of 16 further boxes. So as a result of F2 generation in a dihybrid cross, 16 organisms will be formed. Possibility we are going to show is that of 16. Okay, possibility is that of 16. Now, have you made the square? Done. After this, place all the 4 gametes in the same serial order on one side of the box. Okay, 4 gametes of a single parent on one side of a box. Done. How it is? Capital R, capital Y, capital R, small y, small r, capital Y, small r, small y. Done. Similarly, provide the other parents 4 gametes on the other side. Okay, so this is what, capital R, capital Y, capital R, small y, small r, capital Y, small r, small y. Done. Now, as in your Excel sheets, you people used to give the address to each of the active cell, that is by the row number and the column number, B1, C6, aisa. So, humne yahan pe bhi, ye humne address hi dena hai. Theek hai, we are to give this address to this particular box. Okay, so what the genes are possibly here, you have to combine them. Now, taking care that the combination will always again be, shape should be in front and followed by the color. Second thing, that should be also in a pair. Okay, R's should be in a pair, Y's should be in a pair. You're not going to write RY, RY. Okay, so what the pair is possible here? It is capital R, capital R, capital Y, capital Y. So in this whole box, there is only one organism which is going to show the pure dominant feature. Pure dominant. Only one box, this one, and only one organism. You can see in all the other 15 boxes, this combination is not possible. Right? Pure dominant feature, jo parent ka tha, sabse pehle, starting mein, that parent feature, that is getting its possibility as reduced. है ना. सिमिलरली द अदर पेरेंट दैट इज ऑल्सो स्मॉलर स्मॉलर स्मॉल वाई स्मॉल वाई. दिस इज द ओनली बॉक्स विच इज गोइंग टू गेट दीज फीचर्स. That is only one organism out of 16 again, which is pure dominant. Sorry, pure recessive. This is pure recessive and one which is pure dominant. Okay. Now, as in F1, we got all 100% pure hybrids. Here, the possibility is still less. That is, as you proceed further in generations, the possibility of those characters, they reduces. Possibility reduces. That may appear, but the possibility reduces. How? Now, in this, if you will see that there are the boxes which are diagonally placed. They are the only ones which shows you the same, this one genotype, that is the capital R, small r, capital Y, small y. So see here, it is capital R from here, small r from this side, capital Y from here, and small y from this side. Right? Similarly, it's capital R, small r, capital Y, small y, capital R, small r, capital Y, small y, capital R, small r, capital Y, small y. Okay. So these features, they are the pure hybrids. Now what else? Ye baki boxes mein kya hai? What is there? It is the extra other types of the genotypes which could have been possible because of this independent assortment. Hai na? Independent assort hone ki wajah se hi, it has led to the another genotypes, that is capital R, capital Y, small y, capital R, small r, capital Y, capital Y. Similar way you fill the all these boxes also. Right? So this is capital R, capital Y, small y. Always in a pair, you have to keep the capital alphabet in front, followed by the small alphabet. Okay? So capital R, small y, small y. Small y. This is capital R, capital Y. Then small r, capital Y, capital Y, small r, capital Y, small y. There is nothing like cramming here. You are to only place the genes, right, in the boxes. Done? Anji, done? You can match the genotypes of the various boxes with these one. After this, in every of these boxes, you will be also writing their phenotypes, right? So here, if it is capital R in the pairs, firstly, you will locate in all the 16 boxes whether there is capital R or not. If the capital R is there, you simply write round. Okay, agar is box mein capital R is there, you simply write round, round, round like this. Okay. Give the boxes the phenotype, first phenotype that of the shape. So these are all with capital R's. So give it as round. These four boxes in a corner, they do not have the capital R. So here we will be writing the shape as wrinkled, because the recessive always gets expressed in homozygous recessive condition. So these are all wrinkled. Okay. Now look on to the other feature, that is of the seed color. Color mein, if the box is having the capital Y, you will fill yellow. Okay. So look for this capital Y. If present, write yellow. Round and yellow. Now, for yellow, you have to locate the capital Y. This is round and yellow. Leave the boxes which do not have the capital Y. We will fill them afterwards. Anji. So how many boxes we are left with? That are only four in number again. So these four boxes, right? These four boxes, they will be given the phenotype as green because they do not have the capital Y. So homozygous recessive feature will be expressed, that is green. So round and green, round and green. Similarly, wrinkled and green.
Okay.
Done. Now that we have filled all the phenotypes and the genotypes in the box, Punnett square, forming the F2 generation. Now, what are the possible phenotypes which have been seen here, noticed here? In monohybrid cross, if you remember, we made the phenotypic ratio for tall and dwarf because there were only two features possible. You know? Now, we are counting for more features. Here in the dihybrid cross, we have already studied, we have started studying with the two of the features, you know, simultaneous pattern of the inheritance for two features. So this has led to the more possibilities. That is because of these gametes, which has been produced as a result of the independent assortment, these gametes are going to give the different features. You know, char gametes hain, to char different features isme possible kar paaye. Right? What are the four features? Possibly seen over here in this box. If you can see in the last box, last wale mein dekho, yahan pe last boxes of these rows, you will see all the four possible features: round and yellow, round and green, wrinkled and yellow, wrinkled and green. Right? So these are the possible phenotypes. So now to generate the phenotypic ratio, we are to generate a phenotypic ratio over here. Now for this phenotypic ratio, firstly, write all the four possible phenotypes. पहले चारों possible phenotypes लिखेंगे, फिर उसका ratio बनाएंगे, है ना? So first we are going to mention all the four phenotypes. What are those? First is round and yellow ratio. With second, round and green. With third, that is wrinkled and yellow. Wrinkled and yellow, and last it is wrinkled and green. Done. All these four, now you have to count it from the whole of the box. What is the possibility of getting the round and yellow out of 16? It's 9. Okay, the ratio for this is fixed, that is 9:3:3:1. Okay, this is a fixed ratio. For a dihybrid cross, phenotypic ratio of F2 generation is 9:3:3:1, provided if the parents taken are the pure parents. Okay. Now you will be counting these also from the box. Okay, count for round and yellow. You will have a look on that these are 9 in number, right? All the round and yellow boxes you will count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then 7, 8, and 9. That's it, right? So these are round and yellow are 9. Round and green are 4. 1, 2. Then 3, and the round and green fourth one is 1, 2, 3. And where is the fourth one? Oh, sorry, 3, 3. Right. It is round and green are going to be 3. 3 likha na maine. Okay, so round and green are going to be the 3 offsprings out of 16, which are going to be round and green. Then wrinkled and yellow 3. Ye corner side pe ye tino wrinkled and yellow hai. Theek hai? So these are 3. And the last is wrinkled and green, which is only 1. A total of these numbers gives you 16, and we have created the 16 organisms out here. Okay. So if you get that, what is the possibility of getting round and green in F2 generation of this cross, dihybrid cross, with the two pure parents, then round and green's possibility is 3 out of 16. You will be calculating it for mathematically 3 out of 16 into 100. You will be giving the percentage value if you are asked about the percentage or the possibilities. Okay, right? Any question for today's lecture?